History, Standard 6th. Chapter Number 6, Janapadas and Mahajanapadas. Janapadas. The period from about 1000 BC to 600 BC is considered to be the post-Vedic period. It is in this period that the Janapadas came into existence. Janapadas were the many small states that spread from today's Afghanistan, which is to the northwest of the Indian subcontinent, to Bengal and Odisha in the east, and to Maharashtra in the south. The Janapada called Ashmak occupied a parts of today's Maharashtra. Means the part which was called as Ashmak is now in today's Maharashtra. The names of these Janapadas can be found in Sanskrit, Pali and Ardhamagadhi literature. One can also find information about them in the writings of Greek historians. Historians are the one who writes history. Some of the Janapadas were monarchies. Monarchies means the king is to rule some parts, while some others were republics, means some people were having freedom. Some Janapadas had a Gana Parishad of senior citizens, means aged people. They were having this name were called as Gana Parishad. Members of Gana Parishad came together for discussion and made decisions regarding administrative issues. Means they used to discuss about the administration, how to rule the administration. They used to make some decisions. The place where these discussions took place was known as Santaghar. Gautam Buddha hailed from the Shakya Republic. Every Ganapada had its own coinage. They used to have their own coins. Each and every Janapada were having their own coins. Some Janapadas gradually became stronger and expanded their geographical boundaries. Some Janapadas came to be known as Mahajanapadas. From the literature of that period, it is clear that up to the 6th century BC, 16 Mahajanapadas had acquired special importance. How many? 16 Mahajanapadas had acquired special importance. Kosala, Vatsa, Avanti and Magdha among them became more powerful. Means from these 16 Mahajanapadas, 4 became very powerful. You can see in the picture over here. There are all 16 Mahajanapadas with their capitals. So the Kosala. The Kosala Mahajanapada was located in the foothills of the Himalayas in the region of Uttar Pradesh and Nepal. The famous cities of Kosala were Sharavasti, Kushavati and Saket. Sharavasti was the capital of Kosala. Gautama Buddha had lived in the famous Vihara Jetavan at Sharavasti for a long time. The Kosala king Prasenjit was a contemporary of the Buddha and Vardhaman Mahavir. Later, the state of Kosala merged with Magdha. Means they got together, they came together. Vihara means a Buddhist temple or monastery. The Mahajanapada Vatsa was located in the region around Pragya, that is Allahabad in Uttar Pradesh. Kosam, the capital of Vatsa, was the ancient city of Kaushambi. It was an important center for trade. Trading is to do over there. People used to trade. 3 extremely rich merchants of Kaushambi had built 3 viharas for Gautam Buddha and his followers. King Udayana was a contemporary of Gautama Buddha. After King Udayana, the state of Vatsa could not maintain its independent existence for long. The king of Avanti Mahajanapada conquered the state. The ancient kingdom of Avanti was located in the Malwa region of Madhya Pradesh. Ujjaini, today's Ujjain, was its capital. The city was an important trade center. The king of Avanti, Pradyot, was a contemporary of Gautam Buddha and Vardhaman Mahavir. During the reign of King Nandvardhan, the state of Avanti was merged into the Magdha Empire. The ancient Mahajanapada of Magdha was spread through the region of Gaya, Patna in Bihar and some regions in Bengal. The capital of Magdha was Rajgriha, that is Rajgir. King Bimbisara's palace was built by the architect Mahagovind. Jivaka, the famous physician, was at the court of Bimbisara. Bimbisara had become a follower of Gautam Buddha. You can see in the picture. Rise of Magdha Empire. Ajatshatru, the son of Bimbisara, continued with the policy of expansion of Magdha Empire. He successfully conquered many republics of the East. The kingdom of Magdha prospered during the reign of Ajatshatru. He had become a follower of Gautam Buddha. After the Mahaparivirana of Gautam Buddha, it was during his reign that the first Buddhist council or Sangti was held at Rajgriha. The foundation for the new capital Patligram of Magdha was laid during Ajatshatru's period. Later, it became famous as Pataliputra. Pataliputra was probably in the vicinity of today's Patna city. A noteworthy successor of Ajatshatru was the Magdha king Sheshang. He annexed the kingdoms of Avanti, Kosala and Vatsa to Magdha. Nearly the entire region of northern India came under the control of Magdha. That was how the Magdha Empire took shape. The Nanda kings of Magdha. The Nandas ruled the Magdha Empire between 364 BCE to 324 BCE. They had set up a good administrative system necessarily to run the huge empire. They had prospered a lot. They had a huge four-column army of infantry, cavalry, chariots, and elephants. The Nandas also introduced the system of standard weights and measures. King Dhananand was the last king of the Nanda dynasty. By this time, the Magdha Empire had extended up to the Punjab in the west. However, during Dhanananda's reign, the ambitious youth Chandragupta Maurya, one Pataliputra, ended the Nanda rhyme and laid the foundation of Maurya Empire. Now in the next chapter, we shall read about the foreign invasions on the western and northwestern frontiers of India during the rise of the Maurya Empire. Also, we will read about the Maurya Empire in greater detail. Here are some question answers you have to write it in your history notebook. Thank you.